podcast is sponsored by Charts and Graphs from Q. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 1407, Fix the Chart Scale. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This week, episodes 1405 through 1408, we're taking a look at creating a chart from scratch. In the first episode, 1405, we set up the data. Second episode, 1406, created the chart. Now we want to fix one problem that happens frequently with charts. You'll see here that they ran the scale not from 0 to 100%, but from 74 to 90%. And in essence, they've zoomed in, which while the red people did a lot better than the blue people, they didn't do that much better. When you look at it, I mean, the red is almost 30% larger than the blue, but that's not really the situation. 83 to 89, it was 6 points better, but not that much better. And why does Excel do this? Okay, Excel does this automatically. Take a look at this data here, where they're tightly grouped around 5,000. If you actually just did this chart from 0 to 6,000, you could see no variability at all. So in this case, it certainly makes sense to zoom in here from the, from 4999.5 up to 5,000.5 or so. And you can see the variability between the points. You know, this is if you're in a tightly controlled situation. Maybe these are measurements from a machine and we're measuring variability and you need to be able to see that variability. That makes a lot of sense. You know, but here, I'm not convinced that this is a tight enough that they should have zoomed in. At this size data, it's about 16%. If everything's within 16% on, around 100% or thereabouts, they decide to zoom in. Now, at larger data sets, the percentage is different. So it's some algorithm that's out there. Now, to fix this, we can right-click on the numbers. If you're in Excel 2010, you can double-click the numbers, or you can come to the Layout tab, and then Axes, Primary Vertical Axis, and More. There's a few things here, but not what we need, so always be ready to go to More. In More, these are the settings that we actually need. Okay, so the minimum is set to automatic, the maximum is set to automatic. So let's change that to fixed, and we want to go from zero, fixed, go to 100%. So 100% is one. All right, now a couple of other things we can do here. You'll see that when we went from zero to 100, we're getting a grid line every 10%. That's controlled by the major unit. If you want to have more control, you can actually come in here and say, I want that every 0.25, let's see how that looks, or every 0.2, or whatever you think looks good to you. Now, 0.1 might have been the right thing. Probably 0.1. So they got it right there. But still, you want to go through and have some control. Minor unit, well, I never changed that. That's if we set something up called minor grid lines, and you see that, by default, you never get the minor grid lines, and so I don't have to change that one. Now, some charts, Excel will go from 0 to 100, but then if your data changes, they'll decide to zoom in. So my recommendation, it's really worth the time to come in here and change this from automatic to fixed every time. All right, now tomorrow, in our last in this four-part series, we're going to take a look at some other chart fixes, like the chart title and the legend and the colors. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.